Oh, hey, fellow scientists. Oh, me and I just hiked to the top of a mountain. What? No, I'm not winded. It's just that the air is a lot thinner up here. We're miles above sea level. Ooh. That is a long way down. You know, that makes me wonder. If there were a tall enough mountain, could we hike all the way to outer space? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain how the atmosphere supports life on Earth and describe its layers. Let's investigate. What do you think there is between Earth and outer space? It's something you can't quite see, but it's always there. It surrounds us, keeping us safe and comfortable on our planet. It's called the atmosphere. The atmosphere is the thick layer of air that surrounds the Earth. Think of it like a jacket for our planet. It's mostly made up of a mixture of gases like the oxygen we breathe and water vapor. The atmosphere is held in place by Earth's gravity, which keeps it from drifting off into outer space. This jacket of air makes life on Earth possible. It keeps us warm, lets us breathe, and protects us from dangerous things in outer space. The Earth's atmosphere is split into five layers, and each layer plays a role in supporting life on our planet. Closest to the surface of the Earth, we have the troposphere. This is the layer where all life on Earth lives and breathes. It holds most of the air in the atmosphere, including the oxygen we breathe and the carbon dioxide that plants use to grow. That's a big part of why this layer is so important for life. Tropo means change. Why do you think it's called the troposphere? What kinds of changes do we see happening in the air around us? The weather. The weather is constantly changing. The troposphere is where all our weather happens. In this layer of the atmosphere, clouds form, wind blows, and storms brew. All those steps of the water cycle that we learned about happen here. The troposphere starts at the ground and goes as high as 12 miles above the Earth's surface. So even though Mia and I got pretty high on our mountain hike, we were nowhere close to leaving the troposphere. In fact, no mountain on Earth reaches high enough to escape this layer. So what happens if we go even higher? The next layer of the atmosphere is the stratosphere. As we climb higher, the air starts to spread out and get thinner. There's not enough air in the stratosphere for us to breathe. Maybe it's a good thing no mountains reach that high then. If all the weather we have on Earth happens in the troposphere, what do you think the air might be like above that, in the stratosphere? The stratosphere is much calmer. There are no clouds, no storms, no wind rushing around. Instead, the air stays in smooth, flat layers, which is how this layer got its name. Strato means layer, and the air here stays neatly stacked. The stratosphere plays a very important role in supporting life on Earth. It's where we find the ozone layer, a special layer of gas that protects us from some of the most harmful rays from the sun. Ever been to the beach and forgotten to put on sunscreen to protect your skin? Youch! That painful sunburn? It's caused by strong rays from the sun reaching your skin. The ozone layer is like sunscreen for the whole planet, blocking most of those rays before they can even reach us. Beyond the stratosphere is the mesosphere. Meso means middle, which makes sense because the mesosphere is right in the middle of the atmosphere's five layers. If the air was already thin in the stratosphere, what do you think happens as we go even higher? By the time we reach this layer, the air is even thinner, and the temperature drops to some of the coldest in the whole atmosphere. It would be impossible for us to survive here without special gear. Wait, make a wish! The mesosphere is where we see something pretty magical, shooting stars. But they're not really stars at all. Shooting stars are actually tiny space rocks called meteors that burn up when they enter this layer of the atmosphere. The mesosphere protects Earth by destroying most meteors before they can reach the ground and possibly do harm. The mesosphere works like a shield, helping to protect life on Earth. Above the mesosphere is the thermosphere. Have you seen the word thermo before, like in thermometer or thermos? What do you think it might be like here? Thermo means heat. This layer gets its name because it soaks up a lot of energy from the sun. That energy makes the thermosphere the hottest layer of the atmosphere. The air can get hotter than 3,000 degrees. That's hot enough to melt metal. But here's the wild part. The air is so spread out that if you made it this high, you'd actually feel freezing cold. The thermosphere is where the International Space Station, or ISS, orbits Earth. The ISS is a giant space lab where astronauts from different countries live and work together, doing important research to learn more about space travel, health, and how things work in space, all to help people stay safe on future missions. This layer is also home to a lot of the satellites that help us make phone calls, watch TV, and use the internet. Even though it's far above the Earth, the thermosphere helps us stay connected down below. All right, we've made it to the very top layer of the atmosphere, the exosphere. Exo means outer. This layer is where the atmosphere slowly fades into outer space. The air here is extremely thin, so thin that some scientists don't even consider it part of the atmosphere at all. There's almost no air here, and it's completely silent. It acts like a gateway between Earth and space, where Earth's atmosphere ends and space begins. Let's review everything we've learned today. The Earth is surrounded by a thick jacket of air called the atmosphere. The atmosphere is broken into five layers: the troposphere, the stratosphere, the mesosphere, the thermosphere, and the exosphere. Each layer plays a role in supporting life on Earth. To learn more about the atmosphere, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Well, we made it through all five layers of the atmosphere. Now we know that even if there were a mountain tall enough, we couldn't hike all the way to space. There just wouldn't be enough air to breathe. But even if the other layers aren't as comfortable to live in as the troposphere, each one plays a role in protecting our planet and supporting life on Earth. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! Hey.